Types of relations. Anti-symmetric relation. The relation R is said to be anti-symmetric relation if AB belongs to R and BA belongs to R, then A equal to B. This is called anti-symmetric relation. Now, for example, let me take one relation R on the set of natural numbers such that X divides Y. If X divides Y, then Y divides X, it implies X equal to Y. So that we say that it is said to be anti-symmetric relation. So the definition of anti-symmetric relation is the relation R on the set A is said to be anti-symmetric relation if AB belongs to R and BA belongs to R, then A should be equal to B. This is said to be anti-symmetric relation. Ordered relation. A relation R is said to be ordered relation if it is transitive but not equivalence relation. Next one, partial order relation. A relation R is said to be partial order relation if it is 1. Reflexive, 2. Anti-symmetric, 3. Transitive relation. Example, let R on A is defined by R equal to A equal to take 1, 2, 3 here. R equal to 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. It is partial order relation because clearly it is reflexive relation, clearly it is anti-symmetric relation, clearly it is a transitive relation. So that we say that it is said to be partial order relation, and also it is equivalence relation. This relation is called identity relation. An identity relation is partial order relation, also equivalence relation. Next one is composition of relations. Composition of relations. Let me take R is a relation from A to B. and S is a relation from B to C, then S circle R is a relation from A to C. Therefore, according to this, we say that A comma C belongs to S circle R if and only if A comma B belongs to R and B comma C belongs to S, then it is said to be composition of a relation. Now, properties. S circle R whole inverse is always equal to R inverse circle S inverse. Next one, number of relations. Suppose, let me take a set A. The number of elements in the set A equal to n elements. The number of elements in the set A equal to n elements. Then, the total number of elements in A cross A, number of elements in A cross A equal to n into n equal to n square. The number of elements in A cross A equal to n cube. The total number of relations on A equal to 2 power n into n equal to 2 power n square. The total number of relations on the set A equal to 2 power n square. Total number of reflexive relations equal to on A equal to 2 power n into n minus 1. Total number of symmetric relations equal to 2 power n square plus n by 2. Now, total number of non-symmetric relations equal to total number of relations equal to, we are having 2 power n square minus 2 power n square plus n by 2. So, total number of symmetric relations equal to, we are having 2 power n square plus n by 2. Now we have to subtract 2 power n square plus n by 2 from total number of relations. Then we get total number of non-symmetric relations. Equivalence relation. A relation R is said to be equivalence relation on the set A if it is 1. Reflexive, 2. Symmetric, and 3. Transitive. Theorem. If R and S are two equivalence relations on the set A, then prove that R intersection S is also an equivalence relation. Now, it is given that R is an equivalence relation on the set A. Then clearly we can say that R is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. Similarly, S is also an equivalence relation on the set A. Then clearly S is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. First one. Now we have to prove that R intersection S is also an equivalence relation. So to prove this, first what we have to do is, we have to prove that R intersection S is also a relation. Let R and S be two equivalence relations on the set A. Clearly R is a subset of A cross A and S is a subset of A cross A. Then it implies R intersection S is also a subset of A cross A. So that we can say that R intersection S is a relation since it is a subset of A cross A. Now we have to prove that it is reflexive relation first. Reflexive. Let A belongs to A. Since R is reflexive, we say that A comma A belongs to R, and S is also reflexive, so A comma A belongs to S. It implies A comma A belongs to R intersection S. Since A comma A belongs to R intersection S, we say that it is said to be reflexive relation. Now we have to prove that it is symmetric relation. Symmetric. Let A comma B belongs to A. Let A comma B belongs to A. Since here it is given that R and S are equivalence relations. So clearly R will be symmetric, S also will be symmetric. It implies A comma B belongs to R and A comma B belongs to S. Since R and S are symmetric, it implies clearly we can say that A comma B belongs to R intersection S. Now we have to prove that it is symmetric. whenever it is symmetric, if you want to prove that it is symmetric, now we have to prove that B comma A belongs to R intersection S. Now we have to prove that B comma A belongs to R intersection S. Take A comma B belongs to R. It implies BA belongs to R. A comma B belongs to S. It implies B comma A belongs to S. It implies B comma A belongs to R intersection S. Therefore, since A comma B belongs to R intersection S, then we are getting B comma A belongs to R intersection S. Therefore, we say that R intersection S is symmetric. Now we have to prove that it is transitive. Let A comma B and C belongs to A. Now to prove that it is an equivalence relation, let A comma B belongs to R intersection S and B comma C belongs to R intersection S. Now we have to prove that A comma C belongs to R intersection S. If you prove that A comma C belongs to R intersection S, then we say that it is said to be an equivalence relation. So to prove this, it is a transitive relation. Now to prove this, what we have to do is, first let me take R intersection S is already symmetric, so that we can take it as B comma A belongs to R intersection S and C comma B belongs to R intersection S. C comma B belongs to R intersection S.